Now we'll see about nature of carbon halogen bond. Okay, so in two different compounds we'll see. First one, in haloalkanes. In haloalkanes, this carbon halogen bond is formed by overlapping of sp3 hybridized orbital of carbon and p orbital of halogen, partially filled p orbital of halogen. Okay, when these two undergo overlapping, carbon halogen bond is formed. Okay, clear. So, and for different types of carbon halogen bonds, I have represented here bond energy and bond length. Okay, see here, carbon fluorine bond energy is 105.4 kilojoules per kilocalorie per mole. That means this much amount of energy is required to break this bond. Is this more when compared to other three? Exactly. That means this bond strength is more, and bond length, whenever bond strength increases, bond length decreases. This is due to the smallest size of fluorine atom. This is due to small size of fluorine. We know fluorine is the first member of halogen and its small size is very small. Due to containing the smallest size, its bond is very short. Okay, then more amount of energy is required to break the bond, and bond length is 1.42 angstroms. So this is the shortest bond length compared to other types of halogen compounds. And now see carbon iodine bond. Okay, so it required 57.5 kilocalorie per mole amount of energy. So this is very less when compared to these three. That means less amount of energy is required to break this bond. So that means the distance between carbon and iodine will be increased. Whenever distance increased, bond length also increased. That's why the bond length between carbon and iodine is 2.10. Okay, so based on the size of halogen, bond strength and bond length changes. So this is about the bond length and bond strength or bond energy for different types of carbon and halogens. Now, due to containing some electronegativity difference, okay, due to containing electronegativity difference between carbon and halogen, polarity is created here. Okay, so between carbon and halogen, this is the carbon halogen bond. So between carbon and halogen, halogen is more electronegative, so it tries to take the electrons, bonded electrons, towards halogen. Then halogen will get the partial negative charge. Okay, and here carbon is trying to lose the electron, so it will be getting partial positive charge. That means polarity is created. Why this polarity is created? Due to the electronegativity difference between carbon and halogen. Okay, and this results in dipole moment. So about this dipole moment, we have studied in first year. So dipole moment is indicated by mu, and the units for dipole moment is debye. So if you see the dipole moment for this carbon and chlorine bond or chlorine compound is mu equals to, dipole moment equals to 1.86 debye. And dipole moment of this carbon bromine bond is 1.79 debye, and for carbon and iodine it is just 1.62. Okay, so that is about the polarity. Why polarity is created? Due to having difference, electronegativity difference between carbon and halogen atom. Even this results in the dipole moment. That dipole moment for different types of halogen, it is different. Okay, that is about bond nature of carbon and halogen in haloalkane. Now, we'll see the same bond nature in case of vinyl and aryl halides. Vinyl and aryl halides. So in vinyl and aryl halides, halogen is attached to sp2 hybridized carbon. So it is an example of vinylic compound. Halogen is attached to sp2 carbon. So now here halogen is containing lone pair of electrons. How many? 3 lone pair of electrons are present. In that, if one lone pair of electron is moving here, it will make a double bond. Okay, and immediately the adjacent double bond moves to the another adjacent carbon atom. That means here it is taking electron, so it will be getting negative charge, and this chlorine is losing electron and it is getting positive charge. Now these two resonating structures are formed. If you see the second resonating structure between carbon and chlorine, a double bond, partial double bond is created, so that carbon chlorine bond length decreases. It decreases to 1.69 angstroms from 1.77. this is carbon carbon single bond or carbon chlorine single bond length. But here, such type of carbon-carbon single bond length is not maintained because due to participating in the resonance, a partial double bond character is creating between carbon and chlorine, so that bond length decreases to 1.69 angstroms. Clear? Even we can also explain bond nature in aryl halides. In these aryl halides, what happens? Chlorine is electron donating group. It donates electrons to this position. Then immediately from adjacent position, this bonded electrons moves to carbon. So then we will get here double bond on chlorine atom, and chlorine gets positive charge and this carbon gets negative charge, and these two bonds existing as it is. Now this negative charge will make a pi bond here. Adjacent pi bond moves to another carbon, then it converts to another resonating structure. And double bond Cl with positive charge, here double bond, here double bond is located. Now here negative charge is created. In the next step, negative charge moves here and this pi bond moving here. Okay, then we will be getting double bond Cl with the positive charge and these two pi bonds here, and now negative charge. And finally negative charge make a pi bond here. Pi bond moves to chlorine atom. And we'll be getting the final structure. Double bond here, here and here, and single bond here, Cl, with three lone pair of electrons as it is. Now, these three are said to be main contributing structures of resonance. That is first, second and third. If you observe these three structures, between carbon and chlorine, we can see the partial carbon chlorine double bond. So due to this forming partial chlorine and carbon double bond, the bond length between these two decreased and it becomes very stronger. Okay, that is about the nature of carbon halogen bond in both the alkyl halides, vinyl halides and aryl halides. Now we'll see few questions related to this IUPAC system and classification of haloalkanes and haloarenes. Okay, all these questions are there in your PDF. You just check once. Now I have written the first question. Which of the following halide is secondary? Here they have mentioned common name. How can we say these are common names? Because they are with the prefixes iso, and here iso, here n. That indicates normal, and even here M. So all these prefixes we can write only in common system. So now among all, which is secondary halide that we want to find out? If you try to write the structures of these compound, then it will become very easy to find the secondary halide. Now first write isopropyl chloride. Okay, so prop indicates how many carbons? Three carbons. CH3, CH, CH3, Cl. Okay, this is isopropyl, first structure, isopropyl chloride. Now, see the chlorine atom is attached to this carbon. Is this carbon attached with two other carbons? Exactly. So, we can say it is secondary halide. Like that, write the second structure. Isobutyl chloride. Bute indicates four carbon atoms. CH3, CH, CH3, CH2, Cl. This is isobutyl chloride. Observe the halogen containing carbon. So this is the carbon which is holding halogen. Now this is attached with how many adjacent carbons? Only one. So it is primary halide. Okay. Now write the third structure. That is n-propyl chloride. N-propyl chloride. N indicates all the carbons present in straight chain. How many carbons? Three carbons. CH3, CH2, CH2. Now to this carbon chloride is attached. Okay, now sorry, this is the carbon which is holding chlorine atom, and to this carbon only one carbon is directly attached, so it is primary alkyl halide. Okay, now the fourth one, n-butyl chloride. N indicates all the four carbons present in straight chain. CH3, CH2, CH2, CH2. Now to this carbon chlorine is attached. Now chlorine containing carbon is primary. How can we say primary? Because it is attached directly with only one carbon, so it is primary. That means second one, third one, fourth one are primary halides and first one is secondary halide. Answer is first one. Okay, now move on to the second question. So which of the following is not an allylic halide? What is the nature of allylic halide? In allylic halide, halogen is attached to the carbon, which is sp3, which in turn attached with carbon-carbon double bond. Okay, this is the nature of allylic compound. So now we want to find out among all which is allylic halide. Okay, see, first write the structures. 4-bromo-pent-2-ene. Okay, 4-bromo-pent. Pent means 5 carbons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 2-ene means at second position double bond is present. 4-bromo means 1, 2, 3, 4th position bromine is attached. Now remaining all are single bonds. Okay, now balance with hydrogens. Here are 3 hydrogens, here 1, 2, 3 bonds, 1 hydrogen, here 1, 2, 3, 1 hydrogen, and here 1 hydrogen, here single bond, 3 hydrogens. This is the structure of 4-bromo-pent-2-ene. Okay, now see whether it is allylic or not. See, it is of this type, halogen attached to sp3 carbon which is adjacent to double bonded carbon, so it is allylic. Okay, now see the second structure. See the second structure, that is 2-bromo-2-methyl-butene-1-ene. 2-bromo-2-methyl-butene. First write bute. Bute indicates 4 carbons. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1-ene, that means at first position double bond is present. 3-bromo. 1, 2, 3. At third carbon atom, bromine is present. 2-methyl. At second position, methyl group is located. Okay. Now, balance its valence. Your 2 carbons. So 2 bonds, 2 hydrogens. 1, 2, 3 bonds, 1 hydrogen. A single bond, 1, 2 bonds, so 2 hydrogens. Here also only 1 bond, so it is with 3 hydrogens. Okay. Now this is the structure of 2-bromo-2-methyl-butene-1-ene. Now halogen is attached to which carbon? sp3, which in turn attached with sp2 carbon. So it is allylic. Okay. Now see this third one. 1-bromo-bute-2-ene. Bute means 4 carbons. 1, 2, 3, 4. 2-ene means at second position. First, second position, double bond is located. 1-bromo means at first carbon, bromine is located. Okay, single bond. Understand? Now, CH2, CH, CH and CH3. This is the structure of third one. Okay, now here halogen is attached with sp3 carbon which in turn attached with double bonded carbon. So again it is allylic. Even third one is allylic. Fourth one, 4-bromo-bute-1-ene. Bute means 4 carbons. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, 1-ene means at first position double bond. 4-bromo means at fourth position. 1, 2, 3, 4th. Okay, remaining all bonds are single bonds. Here 2 bonds are present, CH2. Here 2 bonds, CH2. Here 1, 2 bonds, CH. Okay, so not CH. 1, 2, 3 bonds, CH. And here C, CH2. Okay, this is the structure of fourth one. Okay, in the structure, this is the halogen. Halogen containing carbon is sp3 and adjacent carbon is also sp3. Okay. And after that we can see the presence of double bonded carbon. So it is not allylic. Question is which one of the following is not allylic? Which is not allylic? Fourth one. So third one is allylic, second one is allylic and first one is allylic. Allylic means halogen should be attached to sp3 carbon which is adjacent to double bonded carbons. Answer is fourth one. Now we'll see the third question. Write IUPAC name of the given structure. Okay, for this we want to write name. So you just write it completely. So see, bromine CH2 attached to CH2 and it is attached to CH. On the CH2, CH3 are present. So those CH3s I am writing separately. Okay, this is complete structure of this one. And now take the parent chain first. So straight chain or continuous carbon chain will be the parent chain. Next, give numbering. Okay. So for this one, first number, second, third, fourth. At third position methyl group, first position bromine is present. So it is 1-bromo. Okay. Third position methyl. 3-methyl. And totally 4 carbons. Butane. Okay, 1-bromo, 3-methyl, butane. It is there in the options. Okay, you can check. Now move on to the fourth one. Which of the following is primary halide? Primary means halogen. Okay, halogen should be attached to the carbon, which in turn attached with only one another carbon. Then that is said to be primary. Okay, first write the structures of these compounds. So first one, isopropyl halide. Isopropyl halide. First structure I am writing. CH3, propyl. Iso means here. Halide means X. Now see, halogen containing carbon nature. Is it primary? No. So it is attached with two other carbon. So it is secondary. Next, secondary butyl halide. Bute means 4 carbon. CH3, CH2, CH, CH3, X. Secondary means at secondary carbon halogen should be present. Now this is the halogen containing carbon, which is again secondary because it is attached with two other carbons. Okay, next to see third one. Tertiary butyl bromide. Tertiary butyl bromide. CH3, Br. Butyl means 4 carbons, 1, 2, 3, 4. So on tertiary carbon, bromine is attached. So the nature of halogen containing carbon is tertiary. Next, finally, the fourth one. What is the fourth one? Neohexyl. Hex means 6 carbon atoms. Neo means 1 quaternary carbon will be present. So that CH3, C. Okay, quaternary carbon means a carbon which is attached with 4 different carbon atoms. 1, 2, 3, 4 carbons are present, so it is quaternary. Hex means totally 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 are there. Next one, 6th one. CH2 chloride. Cl. Now this is the neohexyl chloride. See, in this neohexyl chloride, quaternary carbon is present, but this is the halogen attached to this carbon. This carbon is directly attached to how many other carbons? Only one. So we can say it is primary. Okay. So what is the question? Which of the following is primary? Only the fourth one is primary. Third one is tertiary. Say first and second ones are secondary. So answer is fourth one. Now we'll move on to the next one. IUPAC name of compound. Okay, so if you have any confusion, you can write it in complete manner. So, or else, I am writing complete manner. At this carbon, double bond is present, and here one side chain, that is CH3, and here two carbon atoms, we can write it, two hydrogens, we can write it as CH2. Okay, again it is attached to this carbon, which already containing two hydrogens, as it is you can write, and along with that bromine is located. Okay, then give numbering. So while giving numbering, unsaturated carbon should get the lowest number. So this is first one, second one attached to third one, and at second position methyl group is present, third position bromine is present. According to alphabetical order, among these two, which comes first? Bromine. So it is 3-bromo, okay, 2-methyl with 3 carbon atoms, propane. Okay, 3-bromo, 2-methyl, propane. Understand? Next, IUPAC name of metadibromobenzene. Okay, it is one of the benzene compound. Meta indicates at first and third position compound group is bromine is present. First write down the structures of these four. First one, 1,3-dibromobenzene. Benzene is present. At first position and third position, bromines are present. This is first structure. Right, second one. 1,2-dibromobenzene. benzene at first position, second position bromines are present. Next, third one, 1,4 dibromobenzene. This is first position, second, third, fourth position bromines. And fourth one, 1,3,5 dibromobenzene. The name itself, it is wrong because they have mentioned three numbers, but they have given dibromo. So it is not the answer. Okay, now the answer will be these three. Now meta. Meta means this is according to common system. So this is the functional group carbon or substituent. This becomes ortho, this becomes meta. Okay, now this is the answer. 1,3 dibromobenzene is IUPAC name of meta dibromobenzene. Meta dibromobenzene. What is its common name? Ortho dibromobenzene. Okay, this is para position, para dibromobenzene. Now the question is, what is IUPAC name of meta dibromobenzene? That is 1,3 dibromobenzene. Next, IUPAC name of this compound. This is almost similar like this. Okay, this is almost similar like this. This is homework for you. You just try to do. So already I have done this fifth question. Okay, seventh question is similar to fifth question. You try to write the IUPAC name of this compound. Okay, now next one. Common name given to. Eighth question is common name given to 2-chloropropane. First write down the structure of 2-chloropropane. So propane, 1, 2, 3. 3 carbons. 2-chloro means at second position chlorine should be present. Okay. At second position or secondary carbon of this propane, if chlorine is contained, that is known as isopropyl chloride. Okay. So according to common system, we can call it as isopropyl chloride. Where it is located? The second option, isopropyl chloride. Many times I have told you. Okay. For this isopropyl chloride. So this is the isopropyl chloride, which is known as 2-chloropropane. Even ninth question is also easy, that I am giving as homework to you. You just try to do that. Next, see the 10th question. Choose the correct one. Choose the correct one. So they have given these questions. You try to write the structures first. Okay, see the first one. Ortho-bromo C6H4. C6H4 means a benzene ring will be present. Okay, ortho-bromo and CH. So CH is present on benzene ring. Within bracket CH3 means upon CH, CH3 is present. Along with that, CH is attached with CH2, CH3. Okay, to this compound at ortho position bromine is present. Is this ortho? Exactly. This is ortho-bromo. Now, is it aryl? Okay, is it aryl compound? Yes. Directly to the aromatic ring, bromine is present. So, it is exactly aryl. Okay, next move on to the second one. At second one, C6H4 again they have given, that is a benzene ring. Okay, at first position, CH2 is present, attached to carbon. Upon this carbon, 3 methyl groups are present, taken thrice. 3 methyl. Those 3 methyls I am writing here. Okay. Next. At ortho. Sorry. Meta position. This is ortho. This is meta. At meta position, which group is present? CH2Cl. CH2Cl. Now, they have given this as benzylic and primary. Is it benzylic? Exactly. Chlorine is attached to sp3 carbon, which in turn attached to benzene ring. So it is benzylic and even primary, because chlorine containing carbon is attached with only one another carbon. Okay, next, see the third one. What is the third one? It is a compound, that is CH3. It is a not open chain compound. CH3 CH double bond CH bond C. Upon C, bromine is present, bond CH3 taken twice. So 2 CH3 groups are present. Okay, now this is the halogen attached to this carbon. This carbon is sp3. Sp3 carbon attached to double bonded carbon. So we can say it is allylic. along with that they have mentioned tertiary. Is it attached with tertiary carbon? Yes, this carbon is attached with three other carbon, so we can say it is a tertiary carbon. Okay, that means all the three are correct, whatever they have given. So the answer is fourth one. Okay, next 11th question, 12th questions almost very easy, similar to the previous questions. You try to do that. Okay, here I have given 9th question, 11th question, 12th question, and then 7th question also homework. So 7. Okay, next we'll see the 13th question. That is IUPAC name of tertiary butyl chloride. Tertiary butyl chloride. That means this tertiary butyl chloride is a common name. So using this we want to write IUPAC name or IUPAC compound. So they have given 4 compounds. You try to write the structures of all the 4. Okay. First one, 2-chloro-2-methyl-propane. Prop means 3 carbons. I am writing the first question. First option structure. Prop means 3 carbons. 2-chloro-2-methyl. This is 2-chloro and 2-methyl. CH3. 4 carbons balanced, sir, 4 bonds are balanced, CH3. This is the first structure. Okay, write its name. Select the pairing chain. Now at second position, which groups are located? Methyl and chlorine. 2-chloro, 2-methyl, propane. Okay, this is the structure of that one. Now, see the second one. 3-chlorobutane. Bute means 4 carbons, 1, 2, 3, 4. Between all the carbon atoms, only single bonds are present. 1, 2, 3. At third position, chlorine is present. So it is CH3, CH, CH2, CH3. This is second structure. Okay. Now, third one. 4-chlorobutane. Butane. CH3. CH2, 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 Cl. Next, fourth one, propane. Prop means 3 carbons. First write that one. 3-methyl. Okay, propane, 3-methyl. 1, 2, 3. 3-methyl. 1,2-dichloro. 1,2-dichloro. Now balance. CH2. CH2, CH3. Okay. Now, which is tertiary butyl chloride? Tertiary butyl means it should contain tertiary carbon. So, this is not containing any tertiary carbon. Even this is not containing tertiary carbon. Even this is not containing tertiary carbon. It is containing secondary. It is containing primary. Even it is containing secondary and primary. So, see the first one. Here, chlorine containing carbon is attached with 3 other carbons, we can say tertiary. Okay, with 4 carbon atoms, we can say tertiary butyl chloride. So, the answer is first one. Okay, so if that means if they have given common name, we can write its structure or we can find its IUPAC names. Okay, this is about the questions related to IUPAC names and classification. You try to solve 9th question, 7th question, 11th and 12th question. So these 4 are the homework for you. Try to do. These 4 are similar to the other questions. Thank you.